Welcome back to the glass plate. In the previous lecture on the glass plate, we discussed what happens to two plates of different material where conduction of heat from one to the other is ongoing. And we looked at it for short times, penetration theory. One of the things that we found out is that at the moment you put these two layers together, almost instantly the interface temperature jumps to a fixed value. And it stays there at least as long as penetration theory holds. Now surely at some point penetration theory will break down. Let us think a little bit about what is happening if time progresses. I'm going to draw the same two plates, bituminous material versus oak, but now flipped by 90 degrees, and I'm going to show what I guess that the temperature difference between the two, the temperature profile do. Initially we had these, colder versus warmer. Heat will penetrate in that direction. So at the first instant there's hardly any heat from one to the other, but nevertheless something like this holds. That interface temperature jumps in immediately. If you wait longer, the heat will penetrate, or the lack of heat will penetrate into the two, but not at the same rate. It goes faster in the bituminous material, as we computed, than in the oak material. So sooner or later, this one is progressing so far that penetration theory doesn't hold anymore. The penetration depth is more than half of this thickness, and I can't use it anymore. And the question is, what will happen to this interface temperature? Will it stay constant? And the answer is no. Most likely, they will have to move. And that's a difficult topic that we will not discuss, but I can try and find what the end result will be. If you wait long enough, the temperature of the two layers must be the same. Let me call this T infinite, as no driving force is allowed in equilibrium anymore. What is T infinite? And is it different from T interface that is initially found for short times? This is not so difficult to compute, and I'm going to use for that a heat balance over this system. Initially, at T equals zero, I can compute the energy content, the heat content, of this system, built out of two layers. So on the oak side, I have that the volume of the oak times its thermal energy, rho CpO, times TO at time equals zero, is a measure of its internal energy, but it's better to start it from some reference temperature that is relatively arbitrary but not too far away, because otherwise you would think that this relation holds from absolute zero, and it doesn't. Okay, the reference temperature is not known, and it will turn out that it's not relevant. It's just setting the energy to a zero level at this temperature, which you can do arbitrarily with temperatures. Obviously I need to add that also the bituminous material carries an energy, so I need to add that for that layer, which is 2 temperature of that minus the same reference temperature that is in computing the energy content. This is the start. Then heat moves over from left to right, but it can't disappear out of the system. So if you wait long enough, T equals infinity, so to say, when stuff is in equilibrium, I have that the same amount of heat, so with an equal sign, must be present in the two layers, but now it is at a different temperature of each of the material, and that temperature for both materials is T inf. So I'm going to write this also for the two layers. All right, what do we have? Initial energy is the same as the final energy in terms of heat. Take a good look. That T reference is sitting everywhere with the same prefactors on both sides. So it drops out of the equation. It doesn't matter what you take. You can take starting temperature of the oak, you can take 10 degrees or lower or higher. It's a quantity that drops out. It's just setting the energy level to zero. Okay, so if I scratch this out, TREFs, and I reread this equation, then there is only one unknown, T infinite. And I can solve that. We have made it simple for ourselves in that the volumes are all the same, because the thickness of these layers is the same, so that drops out as well. If I now try and compute what the final temperature will be, the T inf, I have here still the temperatures of each of the two and their respective rho Cp. And I need to divide that by these two summed up, rho 0 Cp 0 plus rho b Cp b. This equation, the right hand side, has no unknown. I know these temperatures, 20 and 50 degrees, I know these material properties, and thus I can compute what the final temperature will be, and that is, if I did it all right on the computer, slightly more than 31 degrees. And indeed, that is different from the 38 that I found for the interface temperature. So this interface temperature on the way has to drop. And I can't describe that with penetration theory. I need for that the long-term approximation. And this is the very long-term approximation if you want, and I can back out this number relatively easy. Shows you again how simple balances can help you in deciding what happens in the long or in the short run. See you at the next lecture.